Hello everybody, today we are going to see one important theorem, that is midpoint theorem. Okay, so today's our topic is quadrilaterals, some useful facts about a triangle. Okay, this theorem is also known as midpoint theorem. Okay, this is very important theorem. So next year again in class 10 we are going to study this, but now only if you will understand better, then you can continue with this. Okay, so now see what is the statement given. Theorem number 1: the line segment joining the midpoints of any two sides of a triangle is parallel to the third side and equal to half of it. Here the triangle ABC is given. D and E are the midpoints of AB and AC. So according to this, first we will write given. What is given here in triangle? Triangle ABC is given. In triangle ABC, D and E are the midpoints of sides AB and AC respectively. Okay, join DE. Okay, so DE we need to join because it is given in the statement, the line segment joining the midpoints. So DE we will join. So this is point E. Okay, joining the midpoints of any two sides of a triangle is parallel to the third side and equal to half of it. Means DE is parallel to BC. That we have to show. So to prove DE is parallel to BC and parallel to the third side and equal to half of it, means DE is equal to half of BC. Okay, so these two things we need to show with the help of given things and given information. Okay, so now directly we cannot say prove here, so we need to do some construction. Okay, so construction, we need to produce DE to point F, or any point we can use DE to point F in such a way DE is equal to EF. DE and EF are equal, so like that construction we need to do. So say line segment we will produce. Okay, so we will give here name, this is point F, and then we will join FC. Okay, FC. So produce DE to F such that DE is equal to FE. DE and FE are equal. This is my construction. Okay, so and join FC. Okay, so now after the construction we have two triangles, triangle AED and triangle CEF. Okay, if we are able to prove both the triangles, if I want to show both the triangles are congruent, then is it possible? Okay, we will see. AE is equal to AC. AE and EC are equal because E is the midpoint of AC, so definitely AE and EC are equal. Second thing, AED is equal to CEF. These two angles are equal, opposite, vertically opposite angles are always same. And third thing, DE and FE are equal. Okay, so now with the help of side angle side, we can show easily both the triangles are congruent. So first we will read this on the paper. So, proof. in triangle AED and triangle AED and triangle CEF, triangle CEF, okay, we have first AE is equal to EC. Okay, AE and EC are equal because E is the midpoint. E is the midpoint. Okay, second thing, AED is equal to CEF, angle AED is equal to angle CEF. Why? Vertically opposite angle. AED is equal to CEF, vertically opposite angle. And third thing, DE is equal to EF. DE is equal to EF because this is by construction. Okay, like that only construction we have done. DE and EF are equal. So by side angle side, we can say both the triangles are congruent. So triangle AED congruent triangle CEF by side angle side. By SA is correct, okay? Both the triangles are congruent. Okay, if triangles are congruent, if both the triangles are congruent, then we can say AD and FC are equal AD. So AD is equal to FC. AD and FC are equal. Also, we can say angle ADE, angle ADE is equal to angle ADE is equal to this, and this angle will be same, corresponding angles, okay, or congruent angles. So EFC, angle EFC, okay. So this is, I am saying, this is first one, this is second. Okay, what is the reason? By CPC, corresponding parts of congruent triangle. Okay, now AD is equal to FC, angle ADE is equal to angle EFC. Okay, but we know that D is the midpoint of AB. D is the midpoint of AB. So definitely AD is equal to DB. AD and DB are equal. AD is equal to DB because D is the midpoint. D is the midpoint. But here, first statement, what said? AD is equal to FC. AD is equal to FC. AD and FC are equal, but AD and DB are also equal. So can we say DB is equal to FC? DB is equal to FC. DB is equal to FC. Okay. So this is, I am saying, third one. This is very important. Okay. DB is equal to FC. Now we said here DB, and we have given proof DB and FC are equal. Okay. Now we will see how to prove DB and FC are parallel. Okay. DB and FC are parallel. If DB and FC are parallel and equal, DB and FC are parallel and equal, then we can say DBCF is a parallelogram. Then we can say DBCF is a parallelogram. So now we have given proof DB and FC are equal. Now we will prove DB and FC are parallel. Okay. So now here, DF is a line segment. DF is a line segment. Line segment intersects AD and FC at point D and F respectively. Okay, DB, DF is a line segment which intersects AD and FC at point D and F, in which angle ADE is equal to angle EFC. ADE is equal to EFC. ADE and EFC are equal. It means AD and FC are parallel. Okay, because alternate interior angles are equal. So here we can give reason. alternate interior angles. Okay, if alternate interior angles are equal, then we can say AD and FC are parallel to each other. So we can say AD is parallel to FC. Okay, AD is parallel to FC, but AD and DB are equal. AD and DB are equal. So we can say DB instead of AD, we can write DB is parallel to FC. DB is parallel to FC. So this is, I am saying, fourth one. Okay, DB is parallel to FC. Okay, so here we got first. Okay, first thing we proved here. Okay, so DB is parallel to FC. DB is equal to FC. So we can write here one pair of opposite sides of quadrilateral DBCF are equal and parallel. This and this is DB and FC are equal also and parallel. If one pair of opposite side of a quadrilateral are equal and parallel, then we can say that quadrilateral is a parallelogram. So we can write here DBCF is a parallelogram. DBCF is a parallelogram. Okay. If DBCF is a parallelogram, then we can say BC is equal to DF. BC. So BC is equal to DF. BC is equal to DF. Why? Opposite side of parallelogram. Opposite sides of a parallelogram. BC and DF are equal. Okay, opposite side of a parallelogram. So now we can say about DE. DE, we can say DE is equal to half of DF. DE is equal to half of DF. Because like that only construction we have done. DE and EF are equal. That means DF is equal to half of DE is equal to half of DF. DE is equal to half of DF. Okay. But DF and BC are equal. DF and BC are equal. So instead of DF, we can write DE is equal to half of BC. DE is equal to half of BC. So that is our second which we got. Okay. So this is an important theorem. Understood? So see carefully, solve the same theorem in your problem. Okay. Once again, see, in short, I am explaining once again. The question was given here, triangle was given, ABC and D and E are the main points. That was given. So first join DE, then construction produce DE to F such that DE and EF are equal, join FC. Then give the proof both the triangles are congruent. Okay, why we are giving these things? Because all the things are related to each other. If we will not show both the triangles are congruent, we cannot say AD and FC are equal. Okay, we cannot say ADE and EFC are equal. So for that, we need to show both the triangles are congruent. So by side, triangles are congruent, we have given proof. Then AD is equal to FC by simplicity, AD is equal to EFC by simplicity. Then AD and FC are equal, but AD and DB are also equal. So DB and FC are equal. So one pair of opposite side we have shown equal. Then ADE is equal to EFC. So AD is parallel to FC. AD is parallel to FC. If AD is parallel to FC, then DB is also parallel to FC because the same line. Okay. So finally AD and FC are parallel. So in that DB is parallel to FC, DB is equal to FC. So DBCF is a parallelogram. So opposite side BC and DF are equal. So DE is equal to half of DF. So DE is equal to half of BC also. So that is given. Okay. Okay. Now we are going to see the converse of theorem number 1. That is converse of midpoint theorem. Okay. So see here what is given. The line drawn through the midpoint of one side of a triangle parallel another side, intersect the third side at its midpoint. Intersect third point at its midpoint. Okay. So your triangle ABC is given. What is given here? First we mentioned that given the line drawn through the midpoint of one side of triangle. Triangle ABC. In triangle ABC, B is the midpoint. They have told us B is the midpoint of AB. B is the midpoint of AB. And DE is parallel to BC. DE is parallel to BC. See here. The line drawn through the midpoint of one side of a triangle parallel to another side. Parallel to another side. Line drawn one point midpoint of one side parallel to another side means DE is parallel to BC. Okay. Intersect third side at its midpoint. Intersect third side at its midpoint. Means this is the third side. Means here, in short, here we have to show E is the midpoint of AC. E is the midpoint of AC. So that is 2-2. Okay. E is the midpoint. Midpoint of AC. This we need to show. Okay. Just now we have seen theorem. Theorem number 1 is that D and E. If D and E are the midpoints of two sides, then DE is parallel to BC and DE is half of BC that we have seen. Okay, so that reference, with that reference, we are going to give this proof. Okay, so here in proof, we will see here in proof, we have to prove that E is the midpoint. We have to prove that E is the midpoint of AC. We have to prove that. E is the midpoint of AC. E is the midpoint of AC. Okay. Or sometimes we will consider that E is not a midpoint of AC. Okay. For some time we will consider that E is not a midpoint of AC. Okay. So E dash, we will take a point here somewhere, E dash or E prime also we can say. So here figure is given in front of you. E is, if possible, E be not the midpoint of AC. Okay, if possible, we will consider for some time. If possible, E be not the midpoint of AC. Okay, so we will take another point here. Okay, so this is, I am saying, this is E dash or E prime also you can say. So E prime, let E prime or E dash, E prime be the midpoint of AC. Okay, this is given. Okay, we have to prove that E is the midpoint of AC. Okay, but for some time we are considering that E is not midpoint of AC, E dash is the midpoint or E prime is the midpoint of AC. Okay, so now according to the theorem number 1, okay, just now we have seen DE dash is parallel to BC. Okay, if this is the midpoint, then this is parallel to BC. But this is, we will say, first one and second one. What is given? DE is parallel to BC. But actually, what is given? DE and BC are parallel to each other. Or DE is parallel to BC. Okay, here this is second one. Okay, so now this is contradiction to the parallel line axiom. Okay, this contradicts to the parallel line axiom. Okay, what is parallel line axiom that we will see? Okay, see, when two parallel lines are drawn, okay, we know that both the lines never intersect to each other, even though we will extend from both the sides. Okay, but if the condition here it is like that, here we are saying this and this line is parallel to each other, okay, and they are intersecting here. Okay, both the lines are intersecting here. Okay, so DE, both the lines are intersecting here. So definitely DE dash is not, E dash is not a midpoint of AC. Okay, DE dash is not a midpoint of AC. So here we can say this contradicts to the parallel line axiom. So our supposition is wrong. Whatever we have considered, supposition is wrong. Wrong. Supposition is wrong. Okay. So E is the midpoint of AC. E is the midpoint of AC. So E is the midpoint of AC. E is the midpoint of AC. Okay.